Skin. Heat. Hair in your mouth. Feet. Touching feet. Oh, you. And I. Safe from the world. Though the world will try.
I see two paths leading the way into my futures. I see them untangling before my inner eye and see everything their journeys include, see everything these roads pass by. In my mind, I walk both paths till the end. In my mind, I can walk back to the start, can find the way back to the crossroad where these opposing paths first part. But whilst my mind can go back and forth, my own feet can only walk one. And once the first step gives the direction, the other path will come undone. And I see the yellow brick road's shadow, see it untangling to its demise, see my decision leading the way, and the crossroad disappearing before my very eyes. I see two paths leading the way into my futures, but there's always one way I will lose. So standing here at the next crossroad, I wonder how I'm gonna choose. So I know I've already talked about this like a million times, but my friends are really important to me and I like thinking and talking about them, so here we go again. Because as most of you know by now, I have a lot of long distance friendships. It's difficult. Most of the time it's just really difficult and it sucks and I hate that they're all so far away and I want them to be here, but then there are times when it's just really great and amazing and sweet, and I'm extremely happy to have those people even though they are so far away, because we all put in the effort. We all put in the effort to stay friends even though we are miles and miles apart, and I think that every time that happens it just shows me how much those people mean to me and also how much I mean to them, and that's such a great feeling. It's such an amazing feeling to know that someone cares about you enough to make an effort, and at the moment I just have that a lot. I have a lot of those situations where I just feel all gritty and tingly and wonderful because my friends are so great and we're doing such a good job at being friends. I love my friends so much and I love that they love me too.
It's Sunday and tomorrow is the last day of April and I'm ending it in style by meeting my friend Mai and going to a Disney exhibition in the museum, which I think is really, really cool, and I'm pretty excited about it. I'm not quite sure if I'm allowed to film there, but we'll see. If not, I'll just show you the ticket or something. Also, I'm wearing a really twirly skirt, and that's cute. But yeah, let's go meet Mai. Don't tell me money's nothing. Look around, can't get a job, and I work to live, I don't live to work. So my head's all filled with yes I can, and my suitcase packed with my master plan, with my lucky penny swinging round my neck. If I was half the man that I wanna be, with my theme instead to some degree, well the only way that I need to go is up. It's my time to shine on the picket line, and my letters begged on my picket sign.